Okay, so in the earlier class, we have discussed about the coefficient, the relation between the coefficient of a polynomial and its zeros. So as a continuation of the last class, we are doing this question from exercise 2A. This is question number 5. The question it says, if one of the zeros of the polynomial is double the other, then find the value of P and hence both the zeros of this polynomial qx. So in here they have given me a polynomial qx. So given, they have given me a polynomial qx. So q of x, this is equal to x squared plus px plus a. Okay, so they have given me this polynomial. Now this is a polynomial, this is a quadratic polynomial with degree 2. So I'll have two roots. Okay, so I'm assuming these two. I have two zeros, so I'm assuming these two zeros. Okay, so let alpha and beta be the two zeros. Okay, now look at the question. What the question is saying, it says that one of the zeros of this polynomial. So one of the zeros of this polynomial is double the other. Okay, it is double the other. So if my roots are alpha and beta, one of the roots, so that means my beta, this is equal to 2 times of alpha. Okay, so I have this. So this I am putting as equation 1. Okay, so this is coming from question. Okay, this is coming from question. So according to question, the question, I have this part, if one of the zeros is double the other, so I have beta, one of the zeros is double the other, so I have beta is equal to twice of alpha. Now I will use the relations that we have we looked in the earlier classes. So my first relation, it says the sum of the roots or the sum of the zeros is equal to the coefficient, is equal to minus times the coefficient of x by coefficient of x squared. So what are my roots in here, what are my zeros in here? I have alpha and beta. So alpha plus beta, the sum of the roots, this is equal to minus coefficient of x. So minus coefficient of x. What is coefficient of x in here? P. So I have P by coefficient of x squared. So what is the coefficient of x squared? It is 1. Okay, now I'll put the value of beta in here. So from equation 1, we see that beta is equal to 2 of alpha. So if alpha plus 2 times of alpha, this is equal to minus 1. And how, from where I'm putting this value? I'm putting from equation 1. So from equation 1. Okay, I'm getting the value of alpha, I'm getting the value of beta to be twice alpha from equation 1. So from here, what I have alpha plus 2 times of alpha. Alpha plus 2 times of alpha, so this will imply 3 alpha, this is equal to minus p, or alpha is equal to minus p by 3. Okay, so alpha is equal to minus p by 3. Okay, we name this as equation 2. What is the next relation that we know? We know that the product of the roots is equal to the constant term by coefficient of x squared. So, product of the roots. What are my roots in here? Alpha and beta. So, alpha times of beta, this is equal to alpha times of beta. This is equal to constant term by coefficient of x squared. What is constant term in here? 8. So, I have this is equal to 8 by, what is the coefficient of x squared? 1. So, I have by 1. Okay, so what is the value of beta? From equation 1, again from equation 1, the value of beta is 2 alpha. So instead of beta in here, I'll have 2 alpha. So alpha into twice alpha, this is equal to 8 by 1. So alpha into twice alpha, this will be twice alpha squared, which is equal to 8. Okay, so alpha squared, this is equal to 8 by 2, so this and this gets cancelled, so alpha squared is equal to 4. So this I am naming as equation 3. Okay, now from equation 2 I have a value of alpha in terms of p. Okay, now this value of alpha from equation 2 I substitute in equation 3 to get the value of p. So using equation 2 and 3, so from equation using equation 2 and 3, so using equation 2 in equation 3, what do I have? In equation 3 I have alpha squared, and in equation 2 I have alpha to be equal to minus p by 3. So instead of alpha squared, can I put this? Can I put p by 3 whole thing squared is equal to 4. Okay, so what I have done in here, in equation 3 I have replaced the value of alpha to be minus p by 3. Okay, so minus p squared, this will be, I mean minus p whole thing squared, this will be p squared, and 3 squared will be 9. This is equal to 4. Okay, I transfer 9 sets, I have p squared, this is equal to 9 into 4, which is 36. P, this will be equal to root over of 36, but I have to put a plus and a minus sign. Okay, so I repeat once again. So what I have done in here, I have used equation 2 and equation 3. My equation 3 was x squared is equal to 4, alpha squared is equal to 4, and equation 2 gave me the value of alpha in terms of p. So I am using this value of alpha from equation 2 and equation 3. So what I get? Instead of alpha squared, I'll have minus p by 3 whole thing squared. This is equal to 4. So minus p whole thing squared will be simply p squared, and 3 squared will be 9, which is equal to 4. So when I shift this 9 inside, I have p squared is equal to 36. I'm removing the square from the left hand side, so when I do so, I have to introduce the root over sign on the right hand side. Now you have to keep this thing in mind, when I introduce the root over sign, I have to introduce a plus and a minus sign. That means I'm getting two values of p. So from here, the value of p will be equal to plus minus 6. What it means? It means p can either take the value of plus 6 or it can be minus 6. So basically I'm getting two values of p. Okay, so the question is asking me to find out the value of p. Not only that, I also have to find out the value of the zeros of qx. So we'll do that. So I have two values of p, okay, so therefore the values, it's a continuation from there, so therefore the values of p are plus 6 or minus 6. Now when I take these two values, taking different values of p, I'll get different zeros for qx. Okay, so when p is equal to, suppose, plus 6. Yes, when p is equal to plus 6. Now I have this relation between alpha and p from equation 2. So from equation 2, what I have alpha, this is equal to minus p by 3. So instead of minus p, what is my p? P is 6. So I have minus 6 by 3. Okay, so from here, I am getting the value of alpha to be equal to minus 2. And what was the other zero? This is one of the zeros. I have minus 2. What was the other zero? At the beginning, we have seen that my zeros were given, I have taken my zeros in this way. One zero was alpha, the other zero was twice alpha. Okay, or I have written beta, this is equal to twice alpha. Okay, so this is one zero, the other zero will be, and my beta, this is equal to 2 alpha. So 2 alpha, so this will imply 2 into, what is alpha in this case? It is minus 2. So I'll have 2 into minus 2, which is equal to minus 4. Okay, so this is the zeros, this is the zeros when p is equal to plus 6. What will happen if I put p is equal to minus 6? So when p is equal to minus 6, again from equation 1, I mean from equation 2, from equation 2, I have alpha is equal to minus p by 3. So alpha, this will be, what is my p in this case? Minus 6. So I have minus, this minus is coming from here. My p is equal to minus 6 by 3. So I have alpha is equal to minus 6, minus of minus 6 by 3, which, so from here, when I cancel this, I mean when I solve this, minus into minus will become plus 3 and 6 gets cancelled, so this will be plus 2. Okay, what will be the other value, I mean the other zeros? I have my beta, this is equal to twice alpha. Okay, so in this case my alpha is equal to 2. So I have 2 into 2, so this will be equal to 4. Okay, so I have two values of p. So correspondingly, I'll get two pairs of 0. When I take p is equal to 6, I get my 0 to be minus alpha and minus 2 and minus 4. When I take p is equal to minus 6, I get my zeros to be 2 and 4. Okay, so this is the solution for this problem. Okay, so now we'll be discussing about an important algorithm in polynomials, which is your division algorithm for polynomials. What does this algorithm says? It says that the dividend is equal to quotient into divisor plus remainder. Okay, so in polynomials, the dividend we will represent it by using px, the quotient will represent it by qx, the divisor will represent it by gx, and the remainder will represent it by rx. Okay, so this this algorithm will be using for the next set of problems that we'll solve. Okay, so this question I have taken from exercise 2c. The question says divide, they have given us a polynomial, another polynomial. Okay, so I have to divide this polynomial by this polynomial, and then after division I have to verify the division algorithm for polynomials. So again there are two problems, I mean there are two parts. First I have to do the division, and then after doing the division we have to verify the division algorithm for polynomials. Okay, so before doing this we'll assume the polynomials, or we'll name the polynomials. So let, I have the first polynomial, I'm assuming this to be px, p of x, this is equal to 6x squared, 6x cubed plus 11x squared minus 39x minus 65. Okay, so this is the first polynomial, and then the second polynomial, I'm assuming this to be g of x. So g of x, this is will be equal to x squared plus x minus 1. Okay, now the first thing I have to do is I have to do the division. Okay, I have to divide this polynomial by this polynomial. Okay, according to question I have to divide px by gx. So my p of x, it is 6x cubed plus 11x squared minus 39x minus 65. I'm dividing by x squared plus x minus 1. Okay, so to do this division, I look at the first term in my divisor, and I look at the first term, I mean in the dividend, and in the first term in my divisor. So in here I have 6x cubed, in here I have x squared only. So x squared, with what should I multiply so that I get 6x cubed? So I have to multiply x squared with 6x, and when I do so I'm getting 6x cubed. So I have 6x cubed, okay, plus 6x into x will become 6x squared. So I have plus 6x squared, 6x into minus 1 will become minus 6x. So I have minus 6x. Okay, The next step is to do the subtraction. Now when I do this, the sign of this polynomial that I get in here will change. That means my plus sign will change into minus. Again, I have a plus sign, it will change to minus, and the minus sign will change to plus. Okay, now if you notice in here, this term and this term gets cancelled. I have 11 minus 6x squared, so this will be 5x squared. Okay, this will be minus 33x. This term will come down, so I have minus 65. Okay, so the first part is done. Now again, you look at this, I have 5x squared in here, I have x squared in here. What should I multiply? So then I get the 5x squared, I have to multiply x squared with 5. So I have plus 5 in here. Okay, so when I do that, I have 5 into x squared, this will be 5x squared. Plus 5x. Okay, and then minus 5. Okay, again the signs will change, so this is plus sign, so it will become minus. This is plus, again it will become minus. This is minus, it will become plus. Okay, so again this part will get cancelled. Here I'll have minus 38x, and in here I'll have minus 60. Okay, now this portion I cannot divide anymore, right? Because the degree of this polynomial is smaller than the degree of this polynomial, so I will not proceed my division anymore, okay? So, from here, the polynomial that I obtain in here, this is your quotient. And the polynomial that I obtain in here, this is the remainder, okay? So, from here, so from the division, I have the quotient polynomial. So, the quotient which I represent by q of x, this is equal to 6x plus 5. Okay? And the remainder r of x, this is equal to minus 38x minus 60. Okay? So this is the first part of the question. It says divide this polynomial with this polynomial. So I have done that, and then I got these results. Okay, so I have got the quotient at polynomial to be this and the remainder polynomial to be this. The next part of the question, I have to do the verification. Okay, so this is the verification. Okay, what is division algorithm for polynomial? What have we learned? We have learned that the dividend is equal to quotient times the divisor plus remainder. Okay, so what is the what is the dividend in here? The dividend in here is p of x. Okay, so this is equal to gx times qx plus rx. Okay, so this is division algorithm for polynomials. Okay, so to prove this verification, I am taking the right hand side of this equation in here. So what I have g of x times q of x plus r of x, right? So when I put the values, what will I get? What is my g of x? My g of x is x squared plus x minus 1. What is my q of x? Q of x is 6x plus 5 plus what is my r of x? My r of x is minus 38x minus 60. Minus 60. Okay? So we have done the division part, the first part of the question, and I got this result, okay, after the division. Now the second part of the question, it has asked me to verify the division algorithm for polynomial. Now what is division algorithm for polynomial? It says the dividend is equal to the quotient times remainder into divisor plus the remainder. Okay. So what, like in terms of polynomial, how I write this? I am writing this as p of x. This is equal to g of x into q of x plus rx. Okay, so this is my division algorithm for polynomials. Okay? So for the verification, I am taking the right hand side of my of this equation. Okay? So what is the right hand side of the equation? The right hand side, in the right hand side I have g of x, I have q of x plus rx. Fine, now what was gx? Gx, it is x squared plus x minus 1. What is qx? Qx is 6x plus 5. And what is rx? Rx is minus 38x minus 60. Okay, so I'll do the simplification in here. So for the first term, I have 6x cubed plus 6x squared minus 6x. Then I have plus 5x squared plus 5x minus 5. Okay, and then when I remove this, I'm doing this again. So see what I'm doing? I'm bringing the first term from this polynomial. From this polynomial, I'm multiplying with this. Then I'll take the second term, I'll multiply with this. Okay, so I have 6x into this term. So 6x into x squared, this will be 6x cubed. Okay? Plus 6x into x, this will be 6x squared. And then I have minus 6x. Fine? Then I'll take the next term. So I have, when I do so, I'll have 5x squared plus 5x and then minus 5. Okay, so this term I have done. And then now I will remove the brackets in here. Okay, so when I do so, I'll have minus 38x minus 16. Okay, now you should remember this, that I can only add or subtract like terms, that means variables with the same power. Okay, now if you look in here, I have 6x cubed and no other term in this polynomial contains a variable, I mean x with power 3. Okay, so I have 6x in here, I mean 6x cubed in here. Okay, plus I have 6x squared in here, I have 5x squared in here, okay? So I have 6x squared in here, I have 6x squared in here, and 5x squared in here. So I can add these two terms, so I'll get 11x squared. Fine. Then, I have minus 6x, minus 38x. Okay, again I can do the simplification in here, I have this also, minus plus 5. So minus 6x plus 5x becomes minus 1x. And minus 38, this will become minus 39. So minus 39x. And then I'm left with the constant term. I have minus 5 minus 60. So this is minus 65. Okay, now what is this equal to? This is equal to this polynomial that they have given me. Okay, so this is equal to the dividend. So this is equal to p of x. Okay, so from here what we are getting? We are getting this. From here I am getting this. So therefore I can write g of x, okay, into q of x plus rx. When I do this, what am I getting? I am getting p of x. Okay, so this is equal to p of x. Okay, now again, I can write this as p of x, this is equal to g of x plus, into q of x plus r of x. Okay, now what is this? This is the division algorithm for polynomials. Okay. So hence, I have verified the division algorithm of polynomials in this case, okay? So hence verify. Okay, so this is the I mean, this is the solution for this problem. Now, in this question, they have asked us two things. They have asked us to find the divide the polynomial by another polynomial, and also to verify the division algorithm for polynomials. Now, in certain questions, they'll just ask you to divide. Okay, so in those questions, this verification is not required. Okay, the verification part is not required. Just do the division part, just mention the question and remainder, that will be the solution. But in this case, if they have asked you to verify, you have to do the verification part.